What is up, y'all? It's the Eric V, your stream teacher. And you may have been watching a streamer one day and was like, how did they do that cool transition effect to a new scene? And the thing is, I had the same issue as well, and I was wondering, how do I do that? Well, one day, I found out how. And I'm going to use my expertise of now knowing how to do stinger transitions so well that by the end of this video, you'll know how to do it too. Class is in session. I make nothing on YouTube and I have no sponsors. Therefore, this video is sponsored by my very own Patreon page. If you join, you get exclusive benefits like my brand new podcast, demanding what games I play on Twitch, and even music I'm making. And if you become a valedictorian, you will even have the ability to get one-on-one streamer school tutoring to improve your content. If my videos have helped you out in any way, consider contributing. As you can see here, I have my cat Panic in one scene, and if I click to the next scene, it cuts to another video of Panic. And what we're gonna do is get our stinger transition in between these two scenes. So when I click them, they will do that fancy transition you saw in the intro of this video. And I'm going to click the gear here. And once I click on properties, we get to adjust the stinger properties. If you wanna find stinger transitions, you can honestly Google it. You'll see a lot of options. So we're gonna use the same one that you saw in my intro. So I'm gonna browse for that video file. And that is in my documents, stream stuff. And it's called MG Transition Cast Black Blue, because those are the colors. And it matched the color scheme of my stream pretty well, so that's what we did. So I'm gonna click on the first one. There's a few different options here. I'm not sure if the file has to be WebM, but I know you can create your own stinger transitions as well. So anyway, I'm gonna click open on that file. And what you'll notice here is if I click OK and if I try that, it doesn't transition as cleanly as we want it to because it shows that other video a little bit too early. So in order to get that timing right, we have to go back into properties, and that transition point is what we want to adjust. So even though I know what the exact transition point number is for my particular transition, I'm gonna show you, let's just say, I don't know, 450. And we click on it, but we can still see that other video a little bit too early before it properly transitions. So once you get that number exactly right, this transitions happens to be around 700, and you'll know you get it right once you don't see that other video until the transition is fully completed. So when the animation is over, you see the other video, that's how you know that you got that stinger transition in there properly. Of course, if you want to see more of Panic, you can see him at my streams. He's always around. Constantly. Pretty simple, just have the files, put them in there, and it's easy. By the way, that beginning intro, I did that all live with my wireless keyboard and a few hotkeys. It took a while, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked the video and if it helped you at all, of course, like it. Feel free to do that because it helped you for free. The least you can do is hit that little thumbs up. And if you want to ask any questions, feel free to leave a comment or come to my Twitch channel any Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or old school Saturday. And I can help you out with any streaming needs. And there's a Discord link as well. But until next time, class dismissed. I'm keeping that in. You know, I gotta stay at my cobweb. But see, I'm on the internet. I be in the shit that you ain't into yet. I said, when you gonna return? I said, bitch, I ain't enter yet. Ah! Fucking bars, son. That's bars. Enter, return, that's the same button. And I just.